Hello, X-Men fans. This is Solid Dave Snake, bringing you another Throwback Thursday action figure comparison video. And in this video, we are going to compare the Jubilee from the 1995 Generation X line from toybiz compared to the X-Men Marvel Legends Infinite Series Build-A-Figure Jubilee that was just recently released. And there's been a lot of years in between these two figures, and some of the concepts of Jubilee has stayed the same throughout the years, and others have disappeared. Even in this figure, her Generation X version is different than how she first appeared in the comic book when she had the short jeans and the pink tank top and the blue boots and blue gloves. So a lot has changed from there, and then now she has the black suit and doesn't even wear the earrings anymore. But one thing that has always stayed consistent is that long yellow trench coat and her oversized sunglasses. And I will be doing an individual review on this Marvel Legends Build-A-Figure Jubilee the next day after this video is uploaded. But right now we'll just take a closer look at this toybiz Jubilee. And like I said, this is how she looked in the comic book Generation X, which was kind of a spin-off comic, kind of like the New Mutants. It was a newer team of younger, up-and-coming X-Men. And another thing that is similar between these two figures, they both come with energy blasts. I thought that was one thing that was neat. They kind of both look a little similar. But that is this Jubilee single accessory. And she has one kind of crappy action feature, which is if you pull this arm back, it will launch that. So kind of weak. There were weaker ones back then, but they always try to employ these little action features. And if you move it down, you can actually hear it click. And she also comes, if you consider this an accessory, a little X base, which is actually really nice. It holds the figure really well. I like the way they painted it. It really shimmers and shines. And all the figures from this line came with those. But Jubilee herself, the face sculpt and paint really kind of make her look a little weird. She's got that derpy kind of look to her face where she's reverse cross-eyed with both eyes looking in opposite directions. And something's just weird to me with the way her hair is slicked back there and to the side. But back then, this was the only Jubilee figure we had, so if you wanted to assemble the complete cast, you had to get this one. And the coat she comes with is actually really pliable. And I'm sure this figure did not come like this, but over the years I got some kind of black marks on here. And the suit she's wearing underneath kind of runs suit with all the other Generation X outfits that the characters wore in that comic book. It's kind of reminiscent. And articulation wise, this one was very weak, even compared to earlier toybiz X-Men figures that came out. She only has 5 points. She can twist at the head and cut at both shoulders, but this one has that spring feature, and then at both hips. Her legs can go up. So, very limited, kind of a weak figure for back then, but if you wanted a Jubilee, you had to get this one. So, alright guys, stay tuned. Tomorrow I will be putting up a review on that Build-A-Figure Marvel Legends Jubilee. And thanks for watching.